Hi everyone, my name is Day and welcome to Spanglish Generation. If you are new and you appreciate the topics that you see on my channel, I post videos every week and I would greatly appreciate your support by subscribing, liking, and of course, by sharing. I want to talk about a topic that's been impacting our community lately, especially since so many Cubans have decided to break the silence and talk about the realities that Cubans have had to face on and off the island. The term gaslighting has been used a lot on social media lately, and I want to dig deeper into how it's being applied to Cubans in Cuba and the diaspora. Gaslight is a colloquial term defined as manipulating someone psychologically by psychological means into questioning their own sanity. It also says that the term may also be used to describe a person who presents a false narrative to another group or person, which leads them to doubt their perceptions and become disoriented or distressed. I tell you, I've thought about this a lot, and I have to say that I disagree with the narrative. And you tell me if I'm wrong. While it can be definitely frustrating and cause distress, it is my humble opinion that we are using this term in the wrong way, and let me explain why. As victims of a socialist slash communist totalitarian system, our reality is pretty crystal clear. No one with a private account and a profile of a cat, a flower petal, or an anime figure can ever say something that will make us doubt our own reality and experiences. See, we know exactly what we've been through. We know how many times we were discriminated against in our own country. We know how it feels to be oppressed and silenced. We know what it feels like to not have enough of something all the time. We know what it feels like to long for those 4 hours of electricity so you can turn on your freaking fan during the summer. Or waiting for the water to come so you can finally take that shower instead of the good old bucket and cup. There is no amount of gaslighting that can erase all those life experiences. Do you know why? Because so many people risked their lives to change their reality. How dare someone who read about Marx in a book and heard two or three Fidel Castro speeches talking about equality and social justice approach any Cuban who's actually talking about real life in Cuba and tell them they're wrong? How do you explain that? There's something wrong with that picture. I'm sorry, but you don't get to come to me with Google and motorcycle diaries under your belt as enough to debunk over 60 years of people who have been murdered for speaking the truth. You don't get to do that, because the only person who has been psychologically manipulated to question their own reality and sanity is a person who lives in absolute freedom and dares to say they're oppressed. You, my friend, are the true victim of gaslighting. You that still believe that the U.S. is the root of all Cuban evil. Oh, and the U.S. is not innocent, but it's also not fully responsible for Cuba's misery. See, Cuba has a government that made decisions. Those decisions ruined the country. And as Cubans, we are telling you that the embargo is a BS. That the chicken Cubans eat is imported from the U.S. of A. That the incarceration and oppression of minors and peaceful protesters of freedom is not the U.S.'s fault. And that farmers are longing desperately to be able to farm in Cuba in those free lands filled with wheat, but the government won't allow them to farm. Those of you that have bought into that story where they try to sell you the Cuban system as the solution for the problems of capitalism, you are the victim of gaslighting. The media and a couple of idiots have convinced you of how crazy unfortunate you are when compared to Cuba's socialized healthcare, education, and affordable housing. We as Cubans are telling you it is all a lie. So pay attention before you go from becoming a victim of gaslighting to a victim of an oppressive, controlling system from which you dream of leaving. If you're a parent, do you take advice from people who have no children? If you need sex advice or a sex therapist, do you go to a priest? Bad example. The point is, when drawing conclusions about something, the single most important thing you take into consideration is not theory, but practice and experience. And in practice, it is our experience the system in Cuba failed. It is very disrespectful for someone to debate someone who is telling you what they've been through, and you tell them it's not quite like they're saying it, especially when the closest you've been to their experience is spelled G-O-O-G-L-E. Don't think for a second that you are gaslighting me or any Cuban that has had to flee communism. You can try, but by definition, the only manipulated and disoriented perception here, in this case, is yours. Wake up.
When your time comes, don't postpone it. When others doubt and out, you don't condone it. Truth be told, yourself is your toughest opponent. When your moment comes, grab hold and own it. Never let go, stand tall.